Here's the proof that animals are most likely way smarter than us. Thinking all wrong. There's been a lot of talk when it comes to truly understanding the abilities animals have. Think about it. Every day, they have to survive from basically every other species from eating them. Us? Not so much. Some of the most remarkable traits we find in wildlife are extremely important for that particular species. But for some reason, when it comes to comparing them to what we humans do, we tend to believe our capacities are far better. New findings point to superior cognitive abilities in animals. Recent studies point to the fact that while humans and animals may not fully understand each other, that doesn't necessarily mean animals are not smart. We have to compare apples to apples here. Animals have different kinds of intelligent responses to their environments. For example, different species of animals communicate among themselves without words is just a different type of communication. It's probably far superior to us. Imagine being able to coordinate your daily life without speaking. Also, the way animals store and protect their food and offspring, these are clear indicators of a different level of intelligence. Part of the problem is that we tend to look for human traits to judge their capacity, when in reality, they just seem to have different abilities that humans don't. A recent study from Queen Mary University in London found that out of the offspring of bees, humans, birds, and fish, bees came out on top in an intelligence ranking. Here's some more examples. Number 8. Termite cooling. The city of Harare in Zimbabwe is home to a building that's used the best features of the surrounding nature in its country. African termites are known for creating some of the most impressive mounds in the world. Termites build a place where they have everything they need. The best part? They don't even have to go out for food. Given the human conditions they create inside the mound, these termites are actually able to create a specific kind of fungus, which is their primary food source. Who said animals can't be farmers? Seriously, how did termites figure this out? What's really amazing is that they need to create and maintain a temperature of exactly 87 degrees Fahrenheit so that the fungus can appear and thrive in there. So the termites figured out how to create a ventilation system. They constantly open and close heating and cooling vents inside the mound that helps keep the fungus alive. Air enters the lower part of the mound, goes down into an enclosure filled with mud, and then it goes up through a channel to the top part of the mound. And you know what? We actually copied this design. Architect Mike Pierce found the necessary inspiration in termites to create the East Gate Center in Harare. Similarly, the East Gate Center has a ventilation system that functions with different levels of vents allowing air to pass through. This is exactly just like the termites mound. The design makes this building the most eco-friendly building in the country. It manages to regulate its internal temperature while using much less energy than a conventional building. The air enters the building from the bottom and is either cooled or heated, depending on what temperature the air is when it enters. It reaches the top of the building through a group of chimneys. The pair of buildings have a space of separation between them, allowing for a free flow of air that is also captured by fans located on the first floor. The air is then pushed up through vertical spines located at the core of the building. Because of the termite's design, this allows the owners to save up to $3.5 million a year in energy usage. Termites helping us with architecture? No big deal. Wait until you hear about the squirrel. Number 7. Squirrel nuts. Squirrels have an almost enviable way to store their food. When winter is around, many animals resort to storing food in one of two ways. Either they store it completely at their chosen home, or they do like squirrels and manage to hide food in different places. Squirrels are known for hiding their food around different places and then finding it later on. This may seem like a simple task, but we want to remind you, squirrels don't exactly have an iPhone to keep track of things. Squirrels have the very impressive ability to remember where exactly they've hidden their food. It seems like it's an evolutionary trait that allows them to store food in a clever way. It's so clever that there's no way this is a random procedure. There's something going on in their brains that makes them understand why and how to do this at a surprisingly high success rate. Research published in the Royal Society Open Science Journal points out that squirrels not only store food on just memory only, but they also organize the food according to categories. This process of categorizing allows squirrels to remember where they place the item easier. Scientists believe that this isn't just a random strategy. Squirrels are extremely meticulous about where and how they store their food. Although for many years it was thought that squirrels relied solely on their smell to find their food, memory seems to play an important role in the process. This goes out to show important details about a squirrel's capacity to use their brain power. Researchers claim that this organized way of burying, called chunking, gives specific clues about the item they're hiding, a method that decreases their memory load and helps them identify food better. Scientists even believe squirrels do some quality control of the food they found and hidden. And to put the icing on the cake, they also know how to cover their tracks so no one knows that they buried anything there. Oh, wait, did you think that's it? No, they're so smart, they'll just pretend to bury nuts to confuse other squirrels. Number 6, octopus jars. Octopus are probably the smartest animals in the world, if you're asking us. If they actually lived on land, we'd definitely have some stiff competition for the fight as top dog. Octopus are capable of many things. One of them is having emotions. When they're in captivity, they seem to get emotional. In fact, some octopuses become bored and despondent if they don't have any type of activity that motivates them. There was even a case of an octopus that started to eat its own arms. So in order to avoid this, experts working in aquariums all around the world try to find something for octopuses to do. That way, they're putting their mental agility to good use. And that's how the crazy trend of seeing octopuses open jars became a thing. One octopus residing at the Island Bay Marine Center in New Zealand had become quite popular at the aquarium because of its ability to open jars at the blink of an eye. How did his handlers manage to make him interested in the jar in the first place? Well, they placed a live crab inside. The treat in a jar trick has long been a favorite activity to give octopuses in aquariums. Just like humans, octopuses get faster at these tasks with practice. With a fair amount of practice, Ozzy was able to open the jar and get his crab in a time of just 54 seconds. Is that fast or is that slow? Although there obviously isn't an official octopus opening jars record, many other octopus timed come in closer to the 2-minute mark. But opening up a jar is just kinda blah if we're being honest, right? So scientists working at the Seattle Aquarium decided to up the difficulty level by giving their octopus childproof bottles to open instead of plain twist-off lids. The giant Pacific octopus named Pandora was up to the task, but with the extra degree of difficulty. She seemed to be stumped at first, but she was finally able to open her first bottle after about 15 minutes. And of course, after that, she was able to easily twist off the childproof lids in an average of 2 minutes. How are octopus able to figure this out? Octopus are known to be extremely intelligent just in general. They're able to learn and escape mazes, use tools, and distinguish different shapes. It's truly hard to measure just how intelligent they are. Number 5, dolphin bros. Now everyone knows how smart dolphins are, but do you know just how smart? Smart enough to be evil geniuses. Watch this video to learn about animals who are evil geniuses here. Even if dolphins can be giant jerks, not all of them are psychopaths. They do have the capacity to create strong bonds with one another. And not only that, they even do it with humans. But that's kinda a well-known fact nowadays. But what many fail to recognize is that dolphins are undoubtedly the animal with the best memory out there, second to humans. Well, up to date anyways. Recent findings from animal behaviorists from the University of Chicago point to a surprising ability dolphins have. They're able to remember other dolphins whom they've formed a strong bond with. What? Dolphins have bros? Their memory allows them to remember a friend they haven't seen in 20 years. It's definitely not by the looks. They're able to recognize the specific sound of another dolphin they had spent time and created a deep emotional tie with. Yes, even 20 years later. Researchers were able to find this out based on the fact that the registry for dolphins in captivity was readily available. 43 different bottlenose dolphins were studied from different facilities in the US and Bermuda. These were places where dolphins were swapped years before. Scientists had recorded the dolphin whistles from the dolphins that had been swapped and had a record of having made friends with fellow dolphins in the same facility. When these dolphins were played several unrecognizable noises, they wouldn't really pay much attention. But when scientists started playing recording of other dolphins, certain dolphins would start getting closer to the speaker and whistle along. That was a clear sign of having recognized a friend. They also seemed to wait for a response as if having a conversation. Why dolphins need a long-term memory is still unknown, but it may have to do with maintaining relationships since over time, dolphin groups often break up and reorganize into new cliques. This long-term memory allows them to keep a mental registry, much like humans do, of the friends they have and to keep in mind the hierarchy and ranks that they seem to respect a lot. Number 4, ape empathy. Empathy is a difficult trait to measure, even in humans, but recent studies have confirmed that we aren't the only species that's able to show some empathy when surrounded by familiar faces. We're not the only animals to have emotional intelligence. An Italian study has confirmed that there's a remarkable similarity between the empathetic processes in humans and apes. Although there's a slight edge that humans have in very specific moments, the difference between us and apes isn't all that different. The center of comparison is yawning. Yep, yawning. Why? Because yawns are contagious. Research has shown we're more inclined to yawn when someone else is yawning, and it seems like the same behavior has been happening with bonobos for a good while. This is considered to be the basic form of empathy, something called emotional contagion. This is theorized to be present only in humans and chimpanzees. This study performed by the Natural History Museum of Pisa in Italy has managed to do a comparative analysis between us and apes. The team hypothesized that if humans are the most empathetic species, then they should show the most empathetic behaviors at all times. Most empathy tests use interviews and other tasks that animals aren't able to perform. Yawning, however, is something that animals can do. Results show that both humans and apes yawn more frequently when in the company of close friends. The intensity of yawns decreases by a small amount with acquaintances and strangers. The team of researchers then used the data they got using these variables to compare humans and bonobos. The only concrete difference they noticed was that humans tended to yawn more frequently when in the company of close friends. In general, those species would yawn at the same rate when the company was familiar but not close. But some people say that the study was flawed. The bonobos didn't freely interact with other bonobos, and humans who were a part of the study were interacting without constraints. Number 3. Elephant brains. If elephants have taught us anything, it's that their impressive size is an indication of respect. For years, science made us believe that there is a direct correlation between brain size and IQ. Obviously, we can see how this argument fails to make sense. On average, elephants have the largest brains in the wild. With an 11-pound brain, they have astonishingly larger brains than us. Our brains weigh on average around 3 pounds. Now, it doesn't stop there. Elephants, specifically African specimens, are reported to have around 257 billion neurons. We have an average of 86 billion neurons. With this logic, having the largest brain with neuron count, wouldn't they be the smartest creature on Earth? How is it then that we can claim to have the sharpest minds if we fail in comparison to elephants when it comes to the amount of neurons? This is a question that's baffled researchers for years. There is no clear indicator that brain size, brain surface area, or even the amount of neurons are a definitive signal of who's the smartest species. To get a proper answer, we need to shift focus on understanding what's the purpose of each brain. The way an animal is anatomically created to do certain things will determine its capacity to flourish or fail at those things. And that's something much more complex than measuring the amount of neurons. One of the biggest differences that's been found is the placement of neurons. Elephants may have the largest amount, but they only have a third of the amount of neurons we have located at the cerebral cortex. It turns out that most of the complex human functions we consider to be intelligent stem from the cerebral cortex. And that's why humans are considered to be smarter in that realm. Elephants, on the other hand, have a considerable number of brain cells concentrated in the cerebellum, which is used for movement and stability. So really, the main point is, it's tough to compare because it depends on what you're measuring. Neurons will be structured and located in different ways depending on the needs the animal has. This will affect the way an animal processes information, but also enhances their capacity to solve problems that are essential for their specific survival. There really is no conclusive evidence that elephants, or any other animal for that matter, isn't smart in its own way. It goes without saying, elephants really know how to do elephant things. Brain composition, as well as intelligence itself, is a complex subject with so many other factors other than just size and number of neurons. The truth is, we don't really know for sure what makes one species smarter than another. No single measure can explain why some animals are smarter than others, let alone why some of us are smarter than others. Number 2. Rats driving. Rats have finally mastered driving. Their brains are more flexible than we had previously thought. Apparently, rats can master skillful tasks that include, believe it or not, driving. A team of researchers at the University of Richmond in Virginia decided to test out the physical abilities of rats and their ability to learn. Somehow, they decided teaching a rat to drive would help them get to the bottom of this. Using a transparent food container, they made a tiny car. It had a special section with an aluminum bottom and three copper bars that served as a steering wheel. When a rat stood on the aluminum floor and gripped the copper bars with their paws, they completed an electrical circuit that moved the car forward. Touching the left, center, or right bar steered the car in different directions. A total of 17 rats were trained to drive the car in arenas where different food rewards were placed. The food was placed at gradually increasing distance and in different directions. This forced the rats to drive in patterns they've never done before. With time and training, the rats showed an increased ability to reach the food. What's even more surprising than the fact that rats can learn to drive to food is the effect of learning to drive on their overall well-being. Specifically, it's not the driving, but the fact that they overcame a challenge. Scientists measured their stress levels before and after the test. They discovered that the level of the hormone that counteracts stress was increasing progressively as the rats performed the test. Wait, driving relieves stress for rats? This, according to researchers, is a clear indication of how rats lower their stress levels once they mastered a task. This showed their ability to learn and the positive impact that learning can have on the rats. This is a lot like the satisfaction you get when you finish a big project that you've wanted to do. Number 1. Pig Games. The social connotation of a pig is generally a negative one, but they're actually extremely intelligent. They can tell which humans are nice to them and which humans are not. They're able to distinguish between which pigs they know and which pigs they don't. But there are numerous studies that show pigs are way more assertive than we think. They've been found to be mentally and socially similar to dogs and chimpanzees. Overall, pigs are remarkably smart creatures. One recent study shows that they have surprisingly excellent memories. They can be trained to either return to a location where they previously found food or remember where they did not find food so they can forage elsewhere. And the most surprising thing? They're actually able to be socially manipulative. Pigs are actually little sociopaths. They're Machiavellian and strategize about how to outcompete their friends in foraging situations. Watch this next video to learn about animals who are actually evil geniuses.